Jack was stingy and tricky. Stingy and tricky as the day is long. And the days are long in Ireland, where Jack walked the length and breadth of the land, tricking people out of their dearest possessions. He would trick a rattle out of the hands of a newborn baby. He would trick an old priest out of the cane that he used to hobble up the stairs to daily mass. He would trick a bride out of the bouquet that she was about to carry up to the altar. And everything he got by his trickery, he sold for money that he stuffed in his purse and never let go. "Ah, that Jack," people said, "he's trickier than the devil himself." Well, devil doesn't like competition. One day when Jack was walking across the field, the devil came up and tapped him on the shoulder. "All right, Jack, you're coming with me."
"Well, if it isn't the Prince of Darkness himself," Jack said.
"No use arguing with you, I suppose. Who can win an argument with the devil?"
"Still, before I go with you, I do wish I could have one last thing."
"What?"
"Ah, some fruit. Yes, one last piece of fruit, before I leave this good earth, because I suppose once I go with you, I'll be eating gall and wormwood for the rest of eternity."
"All right, what do you want? Peach? Mango? Kiwi?"
"Ah, I think it would have to be an apple, wouldn't it? Since it was an apple got us all in this mess in the first place. And look, we're standing right under an apple tree. Why, saints be praised. Oh, sorry, no offense."
"None taken."
"Now, if you'll just shimmy your infernal self up the tree and pick me an apple, I'll go with you gladly to the gates of hell and beyond."
So the devil wrapped his tail around his waist and started climbing up the tree.
No, not that one. A little higher. No, further up than that. Yes, that's the one. Yes, right to the very top of the tree.
Got it." But when the devil turned to make his way down, Jack had gathered sticks and branches and set them in crosses all around the base of the tree. "I can't come down with those things there. Move them."
"Ah, well now, I wouldn't want to be tampering with the landscape. Might be some kind of crime, you know."
"Move them. I'll give you anything you want."
"Well, there is one thing. Promise me you'll never take my immortal soul."
I promise.
"Say it."
I, the devil, promise you, Jack,
that I'll never take your immortal soul, Cross my heart and hope to die. Don't push it."
So Jack took away all the crosses, and the devil climbed down from the tree and departed in high or low dudgeon. Jack went on to live a long and disreputable life, and when he finally did die at age 97, clutching a baby's rattle in his hand, his soul went straight up to heaven. Saint Peter met him at the pearly gates, crossed his arms, and shook his head.
All right, Jack said. "You can't blame me for trying."
And he went down to the other place.
He was just about to walk through the gates of hell when the devil jumped out in front of him.
"Jack, buddy! Long time no see. How you doing?"
Fair to middling, considering I'm dead now and heaven won't have me. So I'll be joining you forevermore in your infernal kingdom."
"Why are you shaking your head?" "Sorry, Jack. No can do."
"What do you mean?"
"Remember that promise I made? In a certain apple tree?"
"Well, of course, but..."
"A promise is a promise, buddy. My hands are tied. I can't let you in."
"Do you mean I'm going to wander forever, caught between this world and the next, not welcome in heaven or hell?"
"Guess so. Bummer. But wait a minute. Jack, I feel your pain. Here, take this. A little something to light your way."
The devil reached down and tossed Jack a burning coal. It was much too hot for Jack to hold, so he carved out a turnip and used it to carry the coal as a lamp as he roamed the earth. "Saints preserve us. Here comes Stingy Jack and his lantern," people would say. They started putting turnips with candles in them out on their porches to keep Stingy Jack away. And when the people came across to America, they found pumpkins were even better than turnips for holding the candles. So today, when you see a jack-o'-lantern glowing orange in the night, grinning at you from a porch or a window, smile back and say, Thanks, Stingy Jack.